are you not getting the results that you want from your Facebook ads? You might be using the wrong campaign objective. This long yet very valuable video will help you understand more about the objectives and how to choose the right one for your campaign.
Let's cut to the chase.
Hello, hustlers and entrepreneurs. Welcome to another video about Facebook advertising. I might end up giving you the best objective you could have to get the best results out of your Facebook ad campaign. So you better watch until the end. But before that, we need first to review the sales process. This will be your foundation to grasp the basics of advertising and the mindset that you should follow as an advertiser. A sales funnel, or else called sales process or consumer journey, is the marketing term for the journey that potential customers go through on the way to purchase. There are several steps to a sales funnel, usually known as the top, middle, and bottom of the funnel. Although these steps may vary depending on a company's sales model. Here's an example situation. Let's look at the brick and mortar sales funnel. The people at the top of the funnel walk by your store. A certain percentage of them decide to walk in. That's the next step of the funnel. A customer sees a rack of t-shirts on sale. He or she walks to the rack. Now they're at the next step of the funnel. Then the customer selects 4 t-shirts and walks to the checkout. They're at the last step. If all goes well, they finish the purchase and reach the bottom of the funnel. This same process plays out for every business in one way or another. With this funnel, you can categorize your audience into 3 buckets. Number 1, cold audience. Those who haven't seen or engaged with any of your content are called cold audience. They're complete strangers to your brand. Number 2, warm audience. Those who have engaged with your content, visited your page, or watched more than 3 seconds of your video. Number 3, hot audience. This is a custom audience of people who have visited your website, added to cart, or supplied their contact details. Basically, when you talk about hot audience, they're the people who are one step closer to your desired end action. Now that we've discussed the foundations, let's talk about the campaign objectives. Selecting the correct campaign objective is vital, and picking the wrong one can lead to Facebook showing your ads to the wrong people at the wrong time. Here's a rundown of the different ad objectives and when to use them. Now let me share my screen and walk you through it. So as you can see, there are 3 categories of objectives. We have awareness, consideration, and conversion. Bear in mind that this is in line with the sales funnel that we have discussed earlier. The 2 campaign objectives in the awareness category, the brand awareness and reach, are designed to show your ad to the largest number of people in your target audience within your budget constraints. The primary aim of these objectives is to build people's interest in your business by showing your ad to more people. Awareness objectives optimize for impressions, so your ads can be shown to the largest number of people within your target audience. Therefore, clicks and engagement on an ad using this objective will typically be low. If your goal is to drive website traffic or make sales, don't choose one of these objectives because you want to ensure your advertising budget is spent showing your ads to the people who are more likely to visit your website or make a purchase. The brand awareness campaign objective optimizes for impressions. This means Facebook will show your ads to the people who are more likely to remember your ad. Ads Manager will show you estimated ad recall lift data, which is the number of people Facebook estimates would remember your ad if they were asked within 2 days of seeing it. To get the most accurate ad recall data though, you need to carry out a brand lift study. For this reason, brand awareness campaigns are mainly used by larger brands with bigger budgets and the ability to measure these results. Small businesses that want to increase awareness can typically get more tangible results with other campaign objectives. Now let's discuss when to use the brand awareness objective. It's a good option if you want to build a memorable brand and have the means to measure ad recall lift. Now let's discuss the reach objective. The reach objective also optimizes your ads for impressions. Facebook will show your ads to as many people as possible in your target audience within your budget constraints. You might choose this objective if your goal is to get as many eyes on your ads as possible without expecting people to take immediate action after seeing them. So when to use it? Basically, the reach objective is a good choice if you're organizing a local event and the goal is to tell as many people as possible about that event. However, if people need to book tickets in advance, this wouldn't be the most suitable objective. Now let's discuss the objectives under the consideration category. The six consideration campaign objectives, traffic, engagement, video views, lead generation, app installs, and messages, optimize for a specific action such as link clicks or comments. Facebook will show your ads to people within your target audience who are likely to take the action you've chosen. These objectives are designed for low intent actions. So the percentage of people in your target audience who are more likely to take one of these actions will be fairly high. If your goal is to drive sales and conversions, a low intent action brings the risk of low quality leads. So you need to consider that. Now let's go discuss the traffic objective. If your primary goal is to drive traffic to your website, choose the traffic campaign objective and optimize for link clicks or landing page views. Facebook will then show your ads to the people in your target audience who are most likely to click your link based on their previous activity. If you select landing page views at the ad set level, Facebook will prioritize showing your ad to people in your target audience who not only click links, but also wait for your website to open so they can view it. At the ad level of your campaign, choose the destination URL, which can be any target website you choose. If you want to optimize for landing page views, your ad account must be connected to the Facebook Pixel installed on your website. If you want a guide on Facebook Pixel, let me know in the comment section below. Now, let's discuss when to use the traffic objective. This is a good option if you want to send people to your website to read a blog post or look at your menu, let's say if you're a restaurant. Now let's go discuss the engagement objective. If the primary goal of your Facebook ads is to get engagement, go with the engagement objective. Facebook will show your ads to the people in your target audience who are most likely to engage with them. So as you can see here, when you set up an ad with this objective, you can choose from three engagement type options. You have post engagements, you have page likes, and event responses. For the post engagements, engagement from this type of ad includes reactions, comments, shares, video views, and all clicks, and it helps build social proof on a post or ad. However, just as with an organic post, your ad needs to encourage engagement from the audience and give them a reason to interact. If an organic post isn't getting much engagement, turning it into an ad is unlikely to make it more successful. So if you select an ad or a post in your page to run using the engagement objective to gain social proof, then you must select that specific post that has the highest engagement rate. Now for the page likes, if your primary objective is to grow your Facebook page followers, choose the page likes engagement type to reach people who will click to like your page and follow you. This option is available only on Facebook and can't be used to grow your Instagram followers. Now let's go to the third one, the event responses. If you have a Facebook event, you can use this engagement type to get more people to respond to it. However, this is a low intent action, and having 100 people tap going doesn't mean 100 people will attend. So if your goal is to have people buy a ticket or attend an event, you might get better results using the conversions objective and sending people to your website. Now, when to use this engagement campaign? Basically, this is ideal if you want to increase your page fans, add social proof to a certain post, or increase signups to a Facebook event. Now let's discuss the app installs objective. If you have an app and your primary goal is to increase downloads, the apps installs campaign objective is a great choice. Your ads will then be shown to the people in your audience who are most likely to install an app. Clicking the ad will take them directly to their app store to download your app. To get the best results from this objective, you'll need to register your app with Facebook and implement the SDK, which allows you to track the event data from your app in Ads Manager. If you want to have a guide on using the SDK, make sure to comment that below. Now let's go to video views objective. If you choose this objective, Facebook will prioritize showing your video ad to people who are more likely to watch your ad for at least 2 seconds or 15 seconds or more. I'm talking about you should have a video creative, of course. Video views campaigns can help you build trust and awareness with a cold audience. You can create retargeting audiences based on the length of time people watched your video to take them further down to your funnel. To get the most of this campaign, your video needs to capture the audience's attention and deliver the main message in the first few seconds to compel them to continue watching. If your video includes audio, make sure to add captions or subtitles for people who are unable to hear or are watching without sound. Keep in mind that you can use video creative with most Facebook ad objectives, so you would only choose the video views objective if your primary goal is to get people to watch the video and not take an action, such as, let's say, purchase or have a conversation with you afterward. Now let's discuss when to use this particular objective. This is perfect if you want people to watch an introductory video or get more views on your Facebook Live replay. Or maybe you're just explaining something of value to your target audience. Let's go to lead generation objective. The lead generation objective allows you to add a contact form to your Facebook ad. You can also customize the form to ask other qualifying questions if you need to collect more information from the prospect. When someone clicks on your ad, they're prompted to provide details such as their name, email address, and other contact details. Much of this data is already stored on Facebook, so the user can choose to quickly add that information to the form or customize it with the other details. You can download the information collected from the form via your page or have it automatically sent to your CRM using a Facebook partner or via a Zapier integration. Now let's discuss when to use the lead generation objective. This is ideal if you want prospective customers to be able to easily submit their details, but your website doesn't have a sign-up form or isn't optimized for mobile. Let's go to the messages campaign. If your primary objective is to start conversations with people in Messenger or Instagram Direct, the messages campaign objective can be very effective. Facebook will show your ads to the people most likely to send you a message based on their history. Pro tip, make sure you have someone monitoring your inbox and responding to incoming messages within a short period of time. Many users will expect a response within 10 minutes. It's important to let the user know you'll be starting a conversation with them and give a clear reason for doing so. The reason is that users who are unfamiliar with this ad type may be surprised that clicking the ad opens their Messenger app, which can sometimes be perceived as spam. Now let's discuss when to use this objective. It's a good option if you want people to have an opportunity to chat with you or ask questions prior to making a purchase or taking the next step towards working with you. In most cases here in the Philippines, there are small businesses that launch messaging campaigns because they have observed a low cost of advertising. But it should be noted that when it comes to running these kinds of campaign, there's no guarantee that you can get purchases out of these messages. I mean, it depends on your sales process already within the Messenger or the Instagram Direct platform. The reason for this is the messaging campaign is optimized for messages, not purchases. But we'll go on to that particular objective that has a purchases optimization. Now let's go on to the conversion category. For the conversion category, there are conversions, catalog sales, and store traffic objectives. These encourage people interested in your business to buy or use your product or service. These objectives optimize for higher intent actions such as purchase and require some initial setup before you can use them. Conversion objectives often lead to higher costs per impression and link clicks than consideration objective. However, it's important to take all costs into account. The cost per conversion may end up lower overall when using this approach, as your ads will be shown to the portion of your audience most likely to take action. Now, let's go to the conversions objective. If your goal is to reach people who will take a specific action on your website, including adding products to a cart, signing up for a newsletter, or making a purchase, conversions is typically the best objective to start with. use this objective, of course, you'll need to install the Facebook pixel on your website, install the conversions API on your website, verify the domain for your website, and configure your events within Events Manager. At the ad set level, you can choose to optimize for the most relevant conversion events based on your goal, and Facebook will show your ads to the people in your target audience who are most likely to take that action. For example, if your primary goal is to increase sales, use the conversions objective optimized for purchase. Now, when to use this? The conversions objective is ideal if you want to send people to your website with the intention of making a purchase or submitting their details to become a lead. Now let's go to the catalog sales objective. If you're a product-based business, you can create a catalog on Facebook and use the catalog sales objective to show products to your target audience. These are known as dynamic product ads that let you show users a variety of products in your catalog or in your ads, or retarget with specific products based on someone's activity on your website. If you've ever added a pair of shoes to your basket and then had that retailer follow you around Facebook, it's probably because they're using a catalog sales ad in the hope you'll return to buy that item. Using this type of ad requires you to create a Facebook catalog. Facebook will select images from that catalog to use in your ads to make sure they're eye-catching to stop people scrolling through their newsfeed. Now, when to use this objective? It's a good choice if you have a large number of products and want to show potential customers items based on their previous interactions with your business. Now, let's go to the last one. It's store traffic. If you have a multiple brick and mortar stores and want to drive more foot traffic, the store traffic objective can be very effective. Because you can use this objective, you'll need to add all of your store locations to Facebook along with your hours of operations. Facebook will show ads for the closest location to people within a specific radius, which can be set manually or automatically within your store set. So this objective is for businesses with more than one location. If you only have one store, consider using the reach objective to reach your local target audience. Now, when to use this objective? The store traffic objective is perfect if you have more than one store and want people to visit their nearest location. Now let's go answer the question. What's the best campaign objective you can launch? The answer is, it depends. And wait, don't stop this video and say it was just a clickbait, because I have an explanation that you need to always remember. One of the biggest mistakes you can make with Facebook ads is choosing a campaign objective that doesn't align with the results you want to achieve. This puts your campaign at a disadvantage right from the start. The objective you select conveys information to Facebook about your campaign goals and what action you want people to take after they've seen your ad. Based on this information, the algorithm will show your ads to the people in your target audience who are most likely to take that action. If you choose the traffic objective, for example, Facebook will prioritize showing your ads to the people in your target audience who tend to click links. Facebook users are constantly providing information about their behaviors, interests, and actions, and Facebook uses this data to serve ads to the most relevant people. Your campaign objective tells Facebook what you want people to do. Now that you understand how each Facebook campaign objective works, you'll be able to choose the objective most likely to achieve your goal, whether that's to drive traffic, increase sales, or start conversations. The key point to remember is that the objective you choose will influence how Facebook delivers your ads and who they'll be shown to. The results you see in Ads Manager will be based on your campaign objective and optimization choices. To get the best results, consider testing different campaign objectives and make sure you start with the objective aligned closest with your end goal. If you have content suggestions and questions, please let me know in the comments section below. If you need help with social media advertising, contact Corno Media. Follow me on Instagram and on TikTok, and see you on the next video. Bye!